this demonstration of people power, because it's people power in the end that's going to bring down this bloody government. And it's not only us that have taken to the streets here in Auckland. We're hearing reports coming in that Wellington, Christchurch, Nelson, Dunedin, Hamilton, Tauranga, and I'm going to miss somebody out here, I know. Pammy North, there we go. And Humner tomorrow are all taken to the streets. Give them a round of applause, too. 2 weeks ago, we all sang Ding Dong, the witch is dead. And she is, but unfortunately her legacy continues. And what we are facing is 30 years after the election of Margaret Thatcher, after Roger Douglas came to power here, we're still dealing with the filthy greed of the 1% who think that they can steal the assets that were built by our parents and our grandparents. Give them a big boo. Give John Key a big ding dong. Oh, what was that smoke? Yes, Thatcherism unfortunately continues, and this failed policy of privatization is not popular with people. Not just people who vote for Labour, or the Greens, or New Zealand First, or Mana, or whoever. It's also unpopular with people who don't vote. There's a lesson in there, guys. And it's also unpopular with people who voted for the government, who never will again. So these kind of street demonstrations don't need to finish today, they need to start today. Because I can taste blood in the water. I can feel that the tide is turning. Can you? There's something that makes me smile when I see, can I get that echo? When I hear Jerry Brownlee and John Key talk about socialism and communism and the far left taking over. Because they're not, of course. They're not, of course. What we're fighting for is the vision of New Zealand that so many people died and fought for. Only 2 days ago, we celebrated Anzac Day. We celebrated people who thought that they were going off to other parts of the world to defend here. And look what's happening to that country that they built when they came back after the Depression, after two world wars. They said, no more. We want a decent society where we take care of each other, where everybody has a state house, where everybody has the right to go to hospital, and we have collective power. That was what they fought for. And that's why people like John Key and the National Party are traitors. They are traitors to that vision. They are attacking New Zealand. They are selling this country out. Not just the foreigners, but the greedy capitalists who are here in New Zealand as well. Look at the mess that they're making of Christchurch. I'm going to finish on this. I think it's great that we're starting to see big parties like Labour and the Greens talk about state intervention. Give them a round of applause. But I think we should go further. Oh yeah. You know that, I won't disappoint. I think we should take the power back. Not just for electricity, but for the whole shagging thing. Look at our port workers down here. Look at our port workers and how they were treated by that man over there, Len Brown. Now, the state, Auckland, owns the ports down there. Why are they treating our workers so badly? If state ownership is not good enough, if the workers were running down there, I tell you, they do a brilliant job, because that's what they do anyway. And I'll leave you on this. One of the saddest days I ever had in New Zealand was when I met the family of Philola Muliaga. Do people know who Philola was? She was a mother who lived in Mangere Bridge, and her electricity was disconnected under the then Labour government because she didn't have enough money to pay her electricity bill. If we nationalise, if we take control of electricity, it's not good enough that these state-owned enterprises put profit before people. It's time that we did what our parents and our grandparents did and put people before profit. Thank you.
Done that I know you've all done, socialists and organising activism. Our next speaker has been doing the hard mahi for decades, for probably longer than some of us have been around. Please put your hands together for John Minto of the Mana Movement.
Kia ora koutou. Can we start off by giving a big round of applause to the people who are here who are at the front line of the asset sales struggle, and those are the families in Glen Innes who are fighting to defend their state houses. And they've had a hell of a hard time from the police out there night after night. They've been going out to defend our assets. These are our community assets that are being sold by the government. Every Thursday last year they were trucking houses, state houses, out of that suburb to make way for mansions for the wealthy, because the government's selling that land. That's a bloody disgrace. Most political parties support a moratorium in Glen Innes. Mana supports a moratorium, and we say that land is our land. That land is for the people of New Zealand to build affordable housing, not to be sold to the rich. And what do we have? The same thing with electricity. You know, if you read the Herald yesterday, there was a letter there from Alistair Thompson, who's the head of the used to be head of the Manufacturers Association. And Alistair Thompson was complaining. He said, if the Labour Green policy goes through, there'll be $350 million that won't go into investors' pockets. Well, I say, bloody good job! Yeah. That money belongs in the pockets of New Zealanders. It belongs to all of us. It is the collective wealth that our parents' generations built, and we've got this government selling it off to the 1%. So inequality will increase, social problems increase, and we end up with a country that is a shadow of what it should be. Well, Mana's saying no. The other thing I want to say is we need to move to the next stage. We need to say, if this mighty river power sale goes through, the next government, if Mana has anything to do with it, the next government will nationalise our electricity sector across the board and make it serve the people rather than serve corporate interests. Kia ora koutou.
Had enough of this world that serves corporate interests. Thank you, John. Our next speaker, I hope you are all aware of the trouble that Glen Innes Housing has been facing. Can we please welcome one of those very wahine that has been helping to lead that movement, Lisa Gibson of Tāmaki Housing.
Tēnā koutou whānau. He nunui mihi kia koutou. Thank you all very much for coming today, standing in solidarity with us, helping protect our rights, helping protect all our rights. Ngā mihi ki tātou, our Tāmaki Housing whānau, our ladies that have been out there on the front line protecting our homes, protecting our children. It's a hard fight, and even still today, some of our group are looking at being thrown out of their homes in the next few months. So our fight isn't going to stop today. It's just going to get stronger because we see all the tautoko that is being given to us from all the people. Thank you. What's today about? Today is about standing up for our children, for our teachers, for our students at university. It's about standing up for our workers, our port workers, for all our migrant workers that are being treated so badly. Today is about standing in solidarity with one another. Today is about telling this greed-run, national-led government and the supporters, which is the Māori Party, ACT, United Future, that we no longer will tolerate the abuse that your policies are heaping on each and every one of us, on our children, on our future children. We are here to tell you that is enough, and we will do everything within our power to stand up and fight back. We will put it to the Labour Party. We will put it to the Greens. We will put it to the Mana Party, to every other opposition political party that's there, to stand with us in solidarity, to draw a line in the sand, and to finally put people before profit, so that everyone has a home, a decent warm home to live in, so that everyone has a job with a decent pay to take home and support their families, so that the migrant population within New Zealand says, hey, I made the right choice to come and live here in Aotearoa, where the people care, where people before profit. So whānau, once again, thank each and every one of you for standing in solidarity with one another, for standing up and fighting back. I just want to sing you just a quick little song. Māori ora, ora, ora. Ki runga, ki tēnei hikoi. No mai, haere mai, haere mai. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou kākou.
Lisa Gibson and Tāmaki Hansel, thank you very much. Kia ora.